In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. My Lord and my God, I firmly believe that you are here, that you see me, that you hear me. I adore you with profound reverence. I ask your pardon for my sins and grace to make this time of prayer fruitful. My Immaculate Mother, Saint Joseph, my Father and Lord, my guardian angel, intercede for me. Welcome everybody to this meditation on cheerfulness and spirit of service. We have the tendency to be someone who receives, always taking, taking, taking. But it is very important to discover that it is when I give myself to God and to others, when I am a giver, it is then that I really become a cheerful person, when I am a giver. So let us focus on that perspective in this meditation. And the Lord says in the Gospel something very important, that is, give and it will be given to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaking together, running over, will be poured into your lap. For the measure you give will be the measure you get back. If you take a look at what happens in the Gospel, the Lord always brings joy to others by serving them. For instance, in Cana of Galilee, in that wedding where wine was running out, Mary asked our Lord to help out with that problem, to fix that situation, and the Lord made an amazing miracle. And this group of people serving tables just filled up to the brim these jars with water, and as they brought them out to the people in the party, the water turned into wine, and the Lord brought joy to the spouses and to everybody celebrating that wedding, right? You see, the Lord always brings joy to the world. The Lord always gives us a participation in His cheerfulness and in His joy by doing acts of service. That's why service is important. The Lord is telling us, give and it will be given to you. And if we look at what the Lord does, we see that the Lord brings joy to everybody else by doing these acts of service. So that's why it is important that we learn to be givers and to give to the Lord our best and to give to others our best. That's why now in this conversation with the Lord, let us ask Him, Lord, I want to be a giver, not a taker. Lord, I want to be someone who gives himself totally to you and to others. Because that's something we need to ask for, and the Lord will give it to us, and at the same time we have to work on it. Right? So let us ask our Lord for that grace, to be givers, so that we will be people who is joyful and cheerful, and we will be people who bring joy to others. In another occasion, when the apostles were gathered together with Jesus at home, the Lord asked a question to them. What were you talking about on the road? And the disciples didn't answer, because they had been arguing about who was going to be considered the greatest. And they knew that the Lord had told them that if you want to be the first, you gotta be last. Anyone who wants to be first has to be last and the servant of all. The apostles knew that the Lord had told them so many times, and they once and again were arguing about who was going to be considered the greatest. So this is something important. In our nature, we have this tendency to be a bit selfish. In our human nature, we have the tendency to be a bit self-centered, and we need to make an effort to be a bit more generous, to be a bit more centered in other people, those who are around us, so that we can find real joy. So again, let us ask our Lord for this gift. Lord, give me the gift of being the last, so that I will be really the first. And the Lord gave us an example, right? The Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many. So once and again, the Lord gives us an example. And we as Christians, we need to follow the Lord's example. During the Last Supper, the Lord invited his friends to have a good time, to have a nice dinner, and he gave to them the last pieces of advice. He washed the apostles' feet. The Lord had a nice conversation with them. Because the Lord loves us, the Lord treats his friends with this generosity. The Lord is always thinking of serving us, thinking of saving us, thinking of doing what is best for us. And this is exactly the way we find happiness. It is when we serve others that we can find real cheerfulness and real joy. And during the Last Supper, the Lord gave to his friends himself when he pronounced the words of the consecration, right? This is my body. Take and drink, this is the chalice of my blood. The Lord gave himself to his friends, to all of us, because that's what the Lord does, to give himself totally to others. The question is, my friend, do you have this spirit of service? It is when you have this spirit of service that you are really cheerful. For instance, what do you do when your mom says at home, I need a volunteer? What do you do? Do you run away from home? Do you say that suddenly you have a lot of things to do? What's your attitude when someone around you needs you? Are you ready to serve? Are you ready to say yes? That's the spirit of service I'm talking about. Spirit of service starts in small things. Spirit of service starts in serving those who live with you. And we have, during the day, many small occasions to show our spirit of service by helping out at home, doing a favor, saying yes to your mom when she needs someone, these kind of things. So when your mom says, I need a volunteer, what do you do? Do you hide underneath your bed? You have to be always ready to go and serve. Here are a few things you can do to grow in spirit of service that's gonna lead you to grow in cheerfulness. Make your bed in the morning, clean up your room, help out to set table for meals, help out to take away things after meals, help out when someone has to take out the garbage, you know, do the chores that you are entrusted with at home. When someone needs a favor, say yes. When someone knocks on your door, say yes, come in. Be always open to do an act of service to others, because you will find there a lot of cheerfulness. And remember, there is more joy in giving than in receiving. That's why how important it is to ask the Lord, Lord, give me your grace to be a giver, not a taker. And how important it is to work on it as we ask the Lord for it. Eh? In spiritual life, things don't happen by miracles. The Lord gives us his grace, of course, but then he wants us to work on things and to develop our talents and to acquire some virtues and to build up good habits. Eh? So let us ask the Lord to give us his grace to be givers, not takers, and let us work on it every day. And do it with a smile in your face. Because as the scripture says, the Lord loves a cheerful giver. One of the most beautiful parables in the gospel is that one of the Good Samaritan, right? You remember probably the story very well. Long story short, there was this man beaten up by robbers who just threw him to the ditch in a road, in a lonely road somewhere, and they ran away and they left him behind almost dead. And the Lord says that there was a priest going down that road, but the priest didn't take care of this man. Then there was a Levite, and the Levite didn't help this guy either. A priest, who is someone who is supposed to help others, right? Or a Levite. Levites in Jerusalem were the tribe, is the tribe of Israel from which priests come from. So the ones who were supposed to serve others and to serve the people didn't find or didn't want to help this poor man, you know, beaten down and thrown in the ditch. But the Lord says a good Samaritan who was going down that road saw him and felt compassion. And then you know the story. He healed his wounds, he poured on them some oil, he carried the guy on his horse, and they went together to an inn, and this good Samaritan left the guy there and told the innkeeper, I will pay for everything, just please take care of him, etc. You see, it is beautiful to see that there are good people doing good things for others, right? When we see this good that people do for others, you say, wow, this is great. I remember when I was a university student, I used to go every year on Christmas to a very famous street in Madrid, and we would bring there some coffee and blankets for poor people and beggars on the street. And I remember you know, by giving away these coffees and blankets, to see these beggars with a smile in their face because someone was doing something for them. The experience of doing something for others with generosity is something that cannot be paid in this world. The joy you feel deep down in our hearts when we do what is good for others, just because it's good for them and we want to love them, etc., and to show to them some love, that's priceless and fills your heart with joy. That's why when we read the parable of the Good Samaritan, we feel this joy in our hearts, because it's a beautiful story, because this is what we really want to do, to make this world a bit more human, to make this world a better place by putting love in our relationships, right? That's what we do when we serve others, when we do a small favor, and when we do it with a smile on our face. Being merciful and serving others in small details takes some effort, and you have to make an effort, it takes some sacrifice on your side, but that sacrifice fills your heart with joy. Whereas when we are all the time focused on ourselves, focused on my time, focused on what I want to do, focused on the movies I want to watch, focused on the TV shows I want to see on Netflix, etc., 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 and we never find time for God and for others, then little by little our heart shrinks. Huh? Generosity makes us to be a people with a big heart. And that's exactly what makes us happy. What makes us happy is not being selfish. What makes us happy is being the one who serves others, the one who is generous. That's why it is very important, and the Lord wants us to do these small acts of service, because that's the path to be a person with a big heart, and that's the path to be a happy person, a really cheerful person. And yes, you will need the virtue of generosity. It is very difficult to be someone who serves others unless you are generous. And generosity is that beautiful virtue, you know? There is this old story that you probably have heard many times about this beggar who was asking for things, begging for some money and begging for some bread on the street. And he was keeping on a bag all the things that they were giving to him. And, well, he decided to go back home one day, and he was kind of seeing his treasures in his bag, etc. And suddenly he heard a lot of music, and it was like a parade just passing by next to his home on his street. And he just stepped out to see what it was, and he realized that it was the king coming in his parade. And at a certain point, the big chariot of the king stopped right at to his door. So this beggar was in, oh wow, what is this? I am a poor beggar and the king is here. So suddenly the door of the chariot was open and the king stepped down with a solemn attitude, and the king stopped in front of this beggar. This beggar just knelt down in front of the king, and the king told him, stand up, stand up. And then the king extended his hand to this beggar and told him, what do you have for me today? And this poor beggar was kind of, wow, I cannot believe this, is this for real? The king is asking me, a poor beggar, to give to him something. So the guy went, you know, stepped into his house and brought his bag with his treasures, and he gave to the king a small grain of wheat and put it on the king's hand. And the king said, thank you so much, and he kept that grain of wheat in one of his pockets. The king stepped up back to his chariot, and the parade kept going in the street. And then this beggar stepped back home and kept looking at his treasures, etc. And he emptied his bag on a table, and he realized that there, right on his desk, he saw a golden grain of wheat. And then he told to himself, how I wish I had given to him everything I had. It is generosity that fills our heart really with real joy. It is when we give ourselves totally to God and to others that we are receiving without noticing, but we are receiving a lot. So let us work on these things. Let us ask our Lord to be generous. Let us take advantage of the daily opportunities we have to be generous so that we will grow in this virtue of generosity and we will grow in this capacity of a spirit of service that is going to give us true joy. And finally, let us ask our mother to help us in this struggle to be a generous person and to be a person with a spirit of service, because our mother gave us an example. Our mother went to visit her cousin Elizabeth because she knew that Elizabeth was about to give birth, so she was going to need someone around at home. So Mary, as soon as she knew about that, she ran to the mountains and visited her cousin Elizabeth. And when Mary entered Elizabeth's home, Elizabeth was filled with a lot of joy. That's one of the reasons why we call Mary the cause of our joy, because she brought us Christ, you see? So Mary is cause of our joy. So let us ask her to learn to be joyful and cheerful by being people who serve others around us. I thank you, my God, for the good resolutions, affections, and inspirations that you have communicated to me in this meditation. I ask your help to put them into effect. My Immaculate Mother, Saint Joseph, my Father and Lord, my guardian angel, intercede for me.